All right, Alfred Street. It is time for our concert to begin, and I want to invite you all to join me in welcoming the Alfred Street Baptist Church Sanctified Symphony Orchestra. Under the direction of Jamal Lee.
Thank you. the work in the house of the Lord. 6,000 shall be the officers and judges, 4,000 gatekeepers, and 4,000 shall offer praises to the Lord with the instruments I have made. In the first year of King Hezekiah's reign, in the first month, he opened the doors of the house of the Lord and repaired them. He brought the priests, Levites, and assembled them in this square on the east. He said to them, "Listen to me, Levites, sanctify yourselves and sanctify the house of the Lord, the God of your ancestors, and carry out the filth from the holy place." Then Hezekiah commanded that burnt offering be brought to the altar. When the burnt offering began, the song of the Lord began also, and the trumpets accompanied by the instruments of King David of Israel. When whole assembly worshiped, the singers, the trumpeters sounded. All this continued until the burnt offering was finished. When the offering was finished, the king and all who were assembled therewith bowed down and worshiped. Worshiped. Cleansing, sanctification, burnt offerings, and worship. And it all started with the 4,000 tonight. We celebrate the 4,000. The 4,000. And 4,000 shall offer praise to the Lord with the instruments I have made. And 4,000 shall offer praise to the Lord. Tonight we will be cleansed. Tonight we will be sanctified. Tonight we will offer our praise up to the Lord. Tonight we will worship. And 4,000. And 4,000 will offer praise to the Lord with their instruments. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. One word, how would you describe the SSO?
Excellent.
Fantastic.
Spiritual.
It is fabulous.
Exciting.
Blessing.
Black.
Fun.
Powerful.
Time consuming.
Dynamic.
Why do you play with the SSO?
I've been playing all my life, and I enjoy playing with a group that's challenging.
It's one way that I can help people come closer to God through playing through my instrument.
It just motivates me, keeps me young.
I enjoy music and seeing friends.
I enjoy ministering to others, but I found out that it's a ministry to myself.
Because it's fun element.
I play with the SSO because it gives me an opportunity to praise and worship the Lord using my instrument.
It's a way for me to use my talents and gifts that God has given me to give back to Him.
What feeling do you have when you play your instrument?
Cigar gift.
Exhilaration.
Gives me a great feeling of joy.
Peaceful. Calm.
I feel good. I feel powerful.
Vibrations.
I feel peaceful when I play my instrument.
Joy.
What is so great about your section?
Oh, we have mighty brass trumpets. I'm a trumpet player and I'm a brass player, and I just enjoy playing with a brassy sound.
My section is actually the backbone. We are the mighty brass. We have some fantastic players, and we're the ones that actually show up most of the time.
My section is loud and boisterous like me.
Kwame.
The violins sound similar to real voices.
I am the anchor of my section.
My section is really great because we usually have the melody, and that's the pretty part of the song. What is one memorable moment from SSO life?
Just being with the people.
I think it would have to be when we played at the Mark Center. When Pastor Wesley preached for the Southern Baptist Convention, you could tell the people really appreciated us.
It's when we played with Lot Carey and Senior Choir, and
that was just an inspirational moment to like minister. It was like a great combination of music, the voice, all coming together.
When we're on the bus and about to get to a venue, it's a lot of fun to get it, the anticipation and the excitement.
When we went to Eastern Shore and we went in some lovely restaurant and looked like the macaroni was brown or something. I don't know. It was an odd color and nobody would eat it.
Our first performance around Easter time 5 years ago.
A memorable moment from SSO Life was right before a Sunday worship service. We had warmed up to a song and Jamal reminded us to play a little faster. The song is 7 minutes long. Imitate the director, Jamal.
Oh, wow.
I don't want any more talking around here. It's time to go to rehearsal. Let's stop all the talking.
Mr. Tucker, we're about to get started.
Oh man, you're late.
Triple it. Jamal is very patient. He worked with each of us on our various instruments and really encouraged us to keep going higher and higher.
Excuse me, is this mic on?
Okay, good, because I have something to say. Something I need to address, you know, get off my chest, and then I'll be on my way, is that okay? Okay. I am black, African American, once called colored, Negro, and some other words, depending on how far back you go, still. I have the mic, as you are fully aware, so I will use this opportunity to boldly declare that I am black. I am black. Now, I bet you took one look at me and thought you knew that, but I'm not speaking of the color of my skin. I'm speaking more so of the spirit within, the construct of my being, my how, why, and when. And I'm sharing this information in hopes to get to you that my black is an asset and not a threat to you. And maybe once we reach an understanding, we can work together to make the world the best it can be. I am black like the onyx stone of ancient Africa, the land from whence my people come, the stone that is referenced in Revelation as the stone of heaven's very foundation. I am black like the black of the cottonseed that grew into a billion-dollar industry, the seeds of the cotton my forefathers plowed with blood on their backs and sweat on their brows. I am black like the tracks of the underground rail that refused to lose a passenger, that refused to fail. The tracks that would guide and the tracks that would lead them, paving the way from master to freedom. I am black like the words on the picket signs of activists for civil rights, words written by slaves now free, still fighting for equality. I am black as the hair of the fatherless statistic who defied all odds to be our nation's president. I am black like the realms of outer space, black like night that ushers in a new day. Yes, I am black, and all that is in me. I've got onyx in my bones and seeds planted deep. My feet tread the tracks of trails done been blazed by the words of the free and the blood of the slaved. So I will not sit in idle like I have no choice, because my mic is on and I have a voice that I will lift against our nation's flaws, our broken systems and jacked up laws like stand your ground and stop and frisk, and prison pipelines for children at risk, like that message you sent with Dunn and Zimmerman, shoot and miss, you lose, shoot and kill, you win. And that's not all I have to say. There are a few more things we still need today, like justice and freedom and equity for every race, gender, color, and creed. We need extended Medicaid and affordable health care, minimum wage increases and reform welfare, voter rights protection and affirmative acts, less racial profiling and more searching for facts. We need more jobs and better schools and better programs for our youth. We need our voices in our streets and fathers in our homes, because we set the mark and we set the tone for the ones that will follow in the days to come. So we cannot be silent till our work is done. I am black, and I want you to see that come what may, courage did not skip me. All that black that came before me is what I am made of, and I recognize my responsibility to carry the flame of the torch that was lit for me. You may take my history out of your curriculum, but you cannot take this spirit from me. Because black is a color woven into our nation's tapestries with yellows and browns and reds and whites. We all make it beautiful when we shine our lights. We must all do our part so the next generation can boldly stand at this mic and have a different conversation. I am black.
Thank you. Thank you.
guitar.